These super awesome blocks. Guess what? They float. I'm going to build a super tall tower right on top of the water. How high do you think we can go? Let's count. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, six. Do you think we can try one more? Shout if you think I should try one more. Okay, here it goes. Seven. Whoa! That was so much fun. There are many fun things we can do in the water. Things like swimming. Put your arms out and pretend to swim with me. Swish, swoosh, swish, swoosh, swish, swoosh. Oh, and I know something else that we can do in the water. Take a bath. Splish, splash, it's time for a bath. Playing in the water is so great. You can even play tag and squirt your friends with water. Playing with water is so fun.
Who? Who?
It's Ollie.
Hello, Hayden. Who? Who? Playing games with water, are you?
Oh, hi, Ollie. I love playing with water.
I love water, too. It's true. God made it just for me and you. Listen to this story. Just follow me through. Hoo, hoo.
Follow me through, follow me through. Charming Jane, are you thirsty? There's your bowl of water. Good girl. Oh, hi, friends. I'm Carrie the dog walker, and this is my best dog, Stormy Jane. She loves ice-cold water. Raise your hand if you drink water. We all need water, and there is a lot of water in our story today, and I cannot wait to get started. If you're ready to hear a true story from the Bible, wave your hands in the air like this. I think Stormy wants to hear a story too, so let's get started. Whoa! What just happened? Where did everything go? Well, that is actually where our story starts, in the very beginning. In the very beginning, there was nothing. There was no light, there were no houses, or people, or trees, or even dirt for plants to grow in. You're right, Stormy. There were no dogs or other animals. It was empty. There was nothing. But God was there. On day one, when God began creating the world, God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. The whole world was filled with beautiful, dazzling, shimmery light. God looked at all of that amazing light and saw that it was good. Can you say, "It's good"? Ready? It's good. God separated the light from the dark. God called the light day and the dark night. And that's why we have daytime and nighttime. What's the very first thing we do in the daytime? That's right.
We wake up
and get ready for an amazing day of work and play. And after a long, full day, what do we do at nighttime? That's right, Stormy. We get sleepy. So God gave us the nighttime to sleep and rest. On day one, God made light and dark. But do you think that God was finished? No way. God was just getting started. On day two, God made a place for the deep, cool water below and created the wide blue sky above the whole world. That's a good idea, Stormy. Let's remember what God made. On day one, God made light and dark. And on day two, God made a place for the water below and the amazing sky above. Wow, only God can do that. God is so creative and so powerful. God made everything. Oh, hey there, Ollie. Ollie, tell me, who made everything?
God made everything. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who made everything?
God made everything. That's the truth, friends. See you next time. Bye.
So there's your story, and it's all true. God made light and dark and sky above water, all for me and you.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Hoo, hoo.
Wow. First God made light and dark, and then God made the sky above the water. God made everything. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good! I'm gonna try to make my tower even taller before it splashes in the water. See you next time. One, two.
God saw everything he had made, and it was very good. Genesis 1:31. God saw everything he had made, and it was very good. Genesis 1:31.